I just have some thoughts. I just want to get this out. I just want to get this out. Hello. Hi. If you're here because of the kidney discourse and the group chat discourse and the bad art friend discourse, then I'm sorry, but you're in the exact right place to be. First, let me preface this by saying that this whole thing is wild. Like, group chats, kidneys, donating your kidney, and then specifically asking people to care about that and to like congratulate you every single time you bring it up. What? What? But then the extra mile of going out and suing this person to getting to the point with being mad or like being in a fight with someone where you have to literally sue them and then subpoena them to figure out that in all their group chats and all their past texts they've been talking about you. I'm sorry, but you need to like hang out with more, you need to hang out with better people, and you need to find friends. You need to find real friends and better friends and like go to therapy, please. Basically, in this video, I'm gonna be talking about the New York Times article, The Bad Art Friend, or what it means to be a bad art friend, and the article will probably be appeared right here, right now. Basically, for the uninitiated, for those who don't know, the article was pitched to the reporter by this woman who donated her kidney, congratulated herself for it, shared the news with all her writing friends in like a writing group chat or this writing community online in Facebook groups, found out that one of the friends was writing a novel about a woman who donated a kidney. This short story was supposed to be the searing takedown of white supremacy and white privilege and the exploration of all of that through this white woman who donates her kidney to a person of color and expects to be congratulated for it. Long story short, the kidney woman sued the author for using parts of her letter or her posts that she wrote in the group about her kidneys in the actual book. And the suing and the takedown of the author got to be so bad that the author was sued and subpoenaed to release her text messages and her group chat messages all about the original kidney woman who found out that these text messages and group chats and everything were all talking shit about her, about the kidney woman. While the author had been engaged in this email exchange between kidney woman and the author saying that she had never intended to use kidney woman's words in her book and was sorry for any intention that it might have caused, that it might have been what the kidney woman's written about her kidney has ended up in this book. Even explaining that gave me whiplash. I'm sorry, but you should read the article if you want a better in-depth explanation for it, because I'm just going to be talking about it and talking about how this drama just can invade the writing community, and I just have some thoughts about being online and like being a writer. And honestly, the parts that really throw me are just the way that the problem and the email exchange escalated to the point of lawyers getting involved, and then to the extent to which the original author plagiarized the original kidney woman's letter and then denied that she had ever done it. Now, I'm not here to pick a side at all. I'm here to say that both really sound like horrible people, and like just for this issue alone is what I'm saying. For this issue alone, they just sound like either horrible people or people with too much time on their hands and people who just really need to go to therapy and work things out. What I'm trying to say here is that this seems extremely mean girls and extremely high school girls-ish scenario, with all the talking about each other behind each other's back, figuring out what they're saying to each other and to their friends, and the duplicitous nature of how they both communicated with each other, to how communication seemed to break down to a point that there was no other option except for getting lawyers and then preventing literal Boston book fairs from not showing or not giving the author time to promote her book or just flat out pulling her book from shelves at all. That's the crazy part. And I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to articulate this well, but I'm gonna go off a couple tweets that I read, of course also the article. I don't have a script. I'm gonna be saying this all from my mind. Maybe it'll have sounded better there. I don't know. There's only one way to tell. Let me also say that there are so many toxic writing groups out there, and honestly, if there's anything I've learned, that we're all gonna be toxic at one point in our lives. We're all gonna say stupid shit. We're all gonna talk about people behind their backs. We're all gonna bitch and moan about the publishing industry and about other writers and about other authors to each other at some point. Yeah, but the real issue, or when it becomes an issue, I should say, is when communication literally breaks down, that you're either telling people in the group some certain things while also going to other people and telling them different things, and then the whole mess gets escalated until you're literally suing someone and asking book fest organizers to not invite this one specific person to their book fair or to their book festival because of some beef that you had and because of how they wrote about you in their book. Which brings me to another issue, plagiarism. I know that, at least for me, growing up in school, we were all warned about plagiarism. We were all warned about, oh, plagiarism is so bad, plagiarism can get you fined or thrown in jail. That last part is probably not true. I apologize to whoever teacher is watching this and is listening to me and is listening to me for that. It's so funny because plagiarism never feels like a big deal until the person that you're plagiarizing finds out about it. And I think that's true for a lot of things. And I think that has to be true about a lot of things, except not to the point where you can't communicate, to the point that someone has to sue you to find out what you're saying about them, and to find out that your fears about what you wrote was plagiarized was actually confirmed to be plagiarized. So for clarification, the author took a letter that Kidney Woman wrote in this Facebook group, took it word for word, essentially used it as a placeholder for another letter or for a future draft down the line in her novel. She also shared this draft online, so it was available to Kidney Woman. And in that same draft, the author used Kidney Woman's real name as the name of the character who donated the kidney, just like Kidney Woman. Now, I'm not using any names here, but you can definitely look up the article and see for yourself how wild that is. And I'm reiterating a lot of points that have already been made online. Some notable authors that I've been following on Twitter, especially Margaret Owen, Lily Mead, Rachel Hawkins, and Ellen Rosner, are just a few of the major threads that I was following yesterday and throughout the day, who made some very excellent, great points in regards to the whole issue at hand, and I've put their links below so you can definitely check them out. And you can see where I think that I'm going to be coming from in this video, just that it's wild to me that it escalated so much, but it's also completely expected. I think it's also funnier that we all want to watch it and that we all want to see it, because it's such of a train wreck between two very professional literary writers, especially for realistic fiction. I feel like a lot of the discourse surrounding YA boils down to, oh, it's YA. Oh, these writers are writing about teenagers, so of course there's gonna be drama. Of course these writers are gonna emulate the characters that they're writing about because all they ever do is write YA. But here it's actually realistic fiction for like adults, quote unquote adults. It's really amazing if you read the article, because their emails and their communication is all right there. Now, obviously the article does have a very distinct level of bias because Kidney Woman did pitch it to the New York Times. While the New York Times did reach out to the author for comment, she did respond, but because it was pitched by Kidney Woman, we can assume a fair amount of bias from Kidney Woman surrounding the issue and surrounding what it really means to be a bad art friend. I think the other issue surrounding it is just people and open communication, and also internet drama. I can say without a doubt that I've had my fair share of internet drama, whether that's been caused by me, whether that's been caused by other people, whether that's been caused by a huge common denominator of all different factors that weren't well communicated by any given party at any given moment. It's hard to say, but I can at least say that I've had some experience in hashing out and going through internet drama. I don't really know why I'm doing this with my hand, but that's internet drama. Again, when it gets to a certain point, there's always a tipping point where you know that it's gone too far and where you know that it's gone a little bit off the deep end. I will say that everyone is absolutely entitled to their own opinion. Everyone is absolutely entitled to talk shit about other people, whether that's something that you're doing, whether that's something that I'm doing. We all have that right. Again, I feel like when it becomes an issue is that when communication breaks down or when other people find out about it, and then communication breaks down so much that either for whatever reason, one party is unwilling to tell the original person what they're talking about or how they're talking about it, or both of them are upset with how things are being talked about, and then it can escalate into something that shouldn't have affected so many people, especially on the internet, especially in all these like book fairs where the book literally got pulled to such a greater deal than it could have been than if both parties had just communicated well enough in the beginning, or one or both or either of them had just talked about it with other people and left it at that. But that didn't happen, and that usually doesn't happen in internet drama. Most cases, it doesn't explode out into the quote-unquote real world for literary prizes or workshops or book festivals, but it can, as evidence with this, so that's crazy. Be careful what you say on the internet, folks. But one tweet that stood out to me was Helen Rosner, with her point about the tension between writers who define themselves via their writing and then writers who define themselves via being a writer. And that there can be a tendency, especially within the writing community, to define yourself as being a writer, as aka being part of that community. I've said in the past that, yeah, I'm like part of the authortube community. I'm an authortuber. At what point does that identity become who you are and take the place of actually writing? Kidney Woman's identity was really based on being a writer, aka being a part of this community of writers whom she obviously felt comfortable to share anything with and to really consider them her friends outside of like what they all did, which was write. As well as when the author revealed her prioritization of writing, of actually doing the thing versus being a part of the community, being a part of wanting to celebrate what Kidney Woman shared, which was her kidneys, not literally, metaphorically. And that Kidney Woman felt reminded in some way that she wasn't writing, and perhaps she felt threatened by that, which I think comes down to a larger point about identity and about other people's work and stories, and how when people take that just a little bit too far, that the lines are being crossed and the boundaries are also being lost between what it means to be a writer and what it means to be a part of a community of writers. Honestly, that's up to the individual writer to make and to search out community where they can get the most out of what they want, what they specifically want. And you probably won't know what you want. I hope you won't know what you want as far as you not knowing what you want and it growing to be a bigger issue where you have to sue somebody, but hey, maybe we'll all get there someday. But I can confirm that honestly, it's taken me a long time to figure out what kind of writing groups I want to be in and how I want to manage myself in writing groups, even just in the outside larger community. What does being a writer boil down to? That's not going to be one concrete answer. That's definitely not going to be the same answer for me as it is for you. And it definitely wasn't the same answer for Kidney Woman and the author of the kidney short story. Helen's other point about not liking the people that you associate with, that you write with, they don't like you. Go find other people. Yeah, it really sucks to feel excluded. If you're anything like me, that'll probably sit with you for a while. She makes a great point that you have agency. And more importantly, you have agency not to sue those people to figure out what they're saying about you. Because honestly, if you have to sue somebody to figure out that they're talking shit about you, then you probably already know that they're talking shit about you, and they're probably not like the best friends in the world to have. If they even are friends, they might view the group as like a professional networking group. I would say that that's been like a tough thing to learn, especially in the authortube community, because I feel like it's very bottom line practice to share parts of ourselves that we don't necessarily let people or let regular people in our lives have access to. But I feel like because a lot of people get it in their heads that they want to share parts of themselves, whether it's for a story, whether it's because they're drawing on their experience for a story, that they feel like they can share those parts of themselves into this wider network, into this wider group of writers, whether that's just writers on Twitter, Facebook, AuthorTube, etc., Instagram, wherever it might be, you're comfortable level with sharing that kind of stuff may be completely different than mine or somebody else's, and we all have to navigate that. At a certain point, we also have to remember what we're really here for in the community, in the writing community. Are we here to write? Are we here to share experiences of our lives? Are we here to vent? Are we here to write about those experiences of our lives? Which to me feels very different from just talking and venting about those experiences, if that makes sense at all. Rin Chupeko also made a great point about if you want to be a good writer, learn how to roast. Learn how to roast someone you know in real life in stories without using their actual words verbatim to prevent plagiarism accusations, especially if you're going to publish the short story or novel or etc. and make it widely available to a wide audience. If you don't want somebody to know about what you wrote, keep it to yourself, or if you're absolutely confident that nobody will ever see it, then post it. But even then, it'll probably be shown to somebody. Someone will probably see it. The internet is forever. We don't have a lot of control over what's out there already on the internet, if it's already been posted, but we do have control in what we want to post on the internet, and we do have control in what we want to share from our lives, from our writing, etc. Change it from a kidney donation, at least. Change it to a bone marrow donation. Change it to, I don't know, abortion or adoption or anything along those lines, except for using the exact phrasing that the person that you want to talk shit about used. Also, there's a whole other issue about race and white privilege here that I haven't even gone into yet, partly because so many other writers and authors have said it so much better than me, and I don't think that I'd be able to articulate that as well as they do. Lily Mead makes a great point about how the idea of white privilege and like self-centeredness are super, super true coming from Kidney Woman and being implicit in the author's short story and what the author intended to do with her short story. I also feel like there's something to be said about the way that the author of the short story gaslighted the Kidney Woman about saying, oh, no, I didn't use any of your story as inspiration. I didn't use any of it. And then later, only four emails and texts and chats to come out and saying that I literally based the woman in my short story on Kidney Woman. This is why I hate her so much, and etc., etc., etc. Especially something to say about plagiarizing somebody and denying that you're first plagiarizing somebody, only for it then to later come out and be like, nope, I really was plagiarizing you down to the letter, and I knew about it from the start. I knew exactly what I was doing. Again, maybe the main takeaway here is just don't get caught. If you know that somebody is writing or talking shit about you, or even plagiarizing your words, distance yourself from that person as much as possible. And if you can't, if you literally have to get to the point where you're suing them and where you're reaching out to several well-known, well-connected book fairs that are showing the author's short story in order to orchestrate your takedown of this woman, then buddy, you've gone a step too far and you should probably go to therapy. I think that's the moral of this story. Everybody involved should go to therapy. Everybody involved should have an outlet to talk about these issues, because otherwise they're gonna explode and they're gonna escalate and you're gonna get to the point where you're like contacting law enforcement. Should they have sued? Should they have brought this to a court? No, they should have been able to work it out themselves. But honestly, the idea that communication was so off the mark just did not happen so much to the point where it got to be that they were actually suing each other over this issue is pretty crazy to me. The next time that someone says YA authors are full of drama and that we start all the shit, I'm just gonna point them to this article and to point them to this issue where it can happen at any age, regardless of if you think of yourself as Kidney Woman or the author of the short story. Maybe like protect yourself by A, not plagiarizing anybody else's words. Change it enough so that it's different enough except to the very, very few people who understand what you're talking about. B, maybe don't expect a lot from people if they're just gonna fuck you over and not be clear with you about whatever issue that you're asking. At the very least, maybe ask people before you take their words out of context. If you're not friends with that person, or if you have like beef with that person and you're not comfortable for whatever reason asking them, then maybe don't take their words word by word and put them into your story about a person who did the exact same thing that person did. Maybe if it's in a personal essay, that's a whole nother other thing, as this New York Times article stated. But even then, I just think this is bizarre and crazy, but also not too far off the mark from what I've seen happen on the internet. Not too far off the mark from what I've seen happen in group chats. And I think at that point, you owe it to yourself to figure out what works best for you, what works best for you so that you cannot escalate the issue to the point where you have to get a lawyer. I think that's the crazy part about this whole thing, that it escalated to the fact that Kidney Woman was reaching out to all these different event organizers and telling them to blacklist the author because of this plagiarism claim. Now, sure, the plagiarism claim was true. We found that out as evidenced in the article, but still, you've got bad beef enough with a person that you're gonna go ahead and go around to every event that you know this author is going to be at and that you know this person is going to be at, and specifically contact those events and tell them not to work with that author, and just like systematically ruin their life in such a way that you think is your responsibility to do or to owe it to the world somehow, you're probably hanging out with the wrong people. You're probably talking to the wrong types of authors, and you need to work out some issues. And that's my take on Kidney Woman and what it means to be a bad art friend. At the very least, ask people if they're comfortable for you using their words in whatever you're writing. Also, at the very least, maybe just make stuff up that's inspired from what you see. Don't use people's words verbatim. Thank you all so much for watching this. I hope that I got my points across here, and if I didn't, tell me what I did wrong in the comments below. Not too harshly though, this isn't a real in-depth discourse. I'm just making it because I'm so shook, and it's kind of funny when you think about it that this issue pervades every single type of group chat and every single type of writing community out there, I'd say, is the most astounding part. That's all I have to say. Please do check out the links in the description below. They do a lot more thorough job of explaining this issue and explaining their thoughts than I probably have. Thank you all so much for being here. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Hopefully less chaotic, hopefully less book drama to talk about. Bye!